That's me, James Bell. When I became a tech billionaire, it gave me a chance to change the world. So, I built the most revolutionary medical center on Earth, right here in Silicon Valley.
If you place your thumb on the tablet, I can give you full access to the hospital.
Dr. Wallace, welcome to the revolution. This is the wall. It's mission control for every patient. CT scans, MRI, anything that you need to know or the patient wants to know is available at any time. And when it's not medical, the patient gets to choose where they want to be. Pricing over the moon. Studies show that patients sleep better. They have better recoveries if they feel more control over their environment. Mr. and Mrs. Beyer, welcome to Bunker Hill.
You've given us hope. Because of your pregnancy, you chose not to have chemotherapy. At the rate your cancer is growing, we don't have weeks to act. We have days.
If we wait until the fetus is viable, it will be too late.
For our baby?
For both of you. I didn't build this hospital to deliver bad news, so we will find a way to save both you and your baby.
I appreciate what you're trying to do here, but I have to be honest, gadgets and gizmos have been around the medical industry forever. Medicine is ultimately a human endeavor.
Good speech, W. Let me show you why you're dead wrong. This is the E-Hub.
Malik,
show him. You show him. It's an adhesive computer. Monitors everything about you.
How long did it take you to get this program up and running?
8 months ago?
Yeah.
No red tape, doctor. We're pairing the most brilliant minds in medicine with the most brilliant minds in technology. We're gonna get stuff done. This is the revolution, Dr. Wallace.
So, do you think it's possible what James is trying to do?
About 90% of the time that I'm here, I think this can never work. But that leaves a 10% chance that we're actually going to be able to be a beacon for change.
This is Lewis Keating. He's been diagnosed with GSS, Gerstmann-Strasser-Shanker disease.
It's a neurological disease. It's like ALS on steroids.
Also extremely rare. 200 cases worldwide.
Yeah, I have to agree. This case is extremely esoteric.
This is a fascinating disease. I want this patient.
There's only been one case of GSS in the Bay Area in the last 50 years. She had a child she gave up for adoption, August 28th, 1985, your birthday. If I'm gonna even think about uprooting my life to come here, I need to know why you're here, why we're all here. Are we here to save the world? Or are we all here to save James Bell?
How is she doing today?
I think it's time to talk to her parents about taking her off life support. It has been 6 months.
Promised her parents. What am I supposed to say to them?
We can't make those kinds of promises.
We know you won't give up on her, James.
Please don't do that.
You're tense.
That's making me tenser. New scan of Margo's heart. There's only one way to remove the tumor, and a million ways it could go wrong.
What if I could give you a million chances to get it right? And we can print as many as you need. Put up here, Elliot. Come on. Come to Papa.
Okay, everybody, just gather around. I got something to say. Our coma patient. We've been trying to get her to come out to us. I've decided we're gonna stop trying to get her to come to us. We're gonna go to her. Go right to the cerebral cortex. And I thought, well, that's impossible. And then I found this. Brain-to-brain communication.
But it says here that this kind of technology won't be available to the masses for another decade.
Do I look like the masses? They needed funding. We now own this. We're gonna use it to find out unequivocally whether Chrissy is still Chrissy. Because then we know whether there's someone still there to save. You ready?
Yes.
I want you to focus your thoughts on the images that come up on the wall.
She loves animals. We were planning to go on a safari together.
Oh, my God.
The reds and yellows in her cerebral cortex, it all indicates brain activity, consciousness.
Chrissy, it's Dad.
Hi, Daddy.
I should tell you, I did have the genetic test done, and it came back positive for GSS. Over the next 5 years, the man that everybody calls a genius won't be able to remember his own name.
I'm so sorry, James.
I built the hospital for all the wrong reasons, but does that really matter?
I want to be part of this.
James, your new transfer arrived. GSS patient.
Mr. Keating. Welcome to Bunker Hill.
unsteady, a little unsteady.